Hello, my name is Indiana, and today we're going to be talking about three chemical concepts. So our first chemical concept that we're going to be talking about is cooking fuel. Cooking fuel is made of methane. So when you turn on the stove, that blue flame that you see is methane. Methane is made up of petroleum product, which is convenient of a condensed chemical energy. So when you're burning methane, it's combustion. It's called combustion. From combustion, it goes to heat energy, and from heat energy, it's what cooks your food. So we're going to be talking about combustion of methane. Right here is the equation. Here's the chemical energy right here going to the heat energy. Right here are other products of petroleum right here. All of these are other products of petroleum. Okay, so the second chemistry thing we're going to be talking about is heat capacity of cookware. We're going to list the materials, the pros, the cons, and the specific heat. Right here, for copper, the pro is that it's a great conductor. That's why in the pans, copper is mostly on the bottom. The con is that it costs a lot of money. It reacts with food. The specific heat is 0.390 joules. For iron, it's a great heat conductor. It's cheap, but the cons is that it's heavy. It gets rust with water. It has 0.470 joules. For stainless steel, as you can see here, which is the pan, it's non-reactive with food, so that's good. It cleans easily, but the con is that it's processed. The specific heat is 0.500 joules. For the silicone, so here's part of the silicone. It's heat resistant. You don't burn yourself when you touch it. And water, I have water here to show how the specific heat of these are so much lower than water. As you can see, it's 4.184 joules. So you need a lot of things to connect to get heat so they could warm up water. Although Dominique's going to be using Teflon to cook the eggs and pans. Although all of this is important because without it, we would be paying a lot of money. So materials that are energy efficient to reduce energy gas can lower our bill cost. Okay, so this is our third chemical concept we're going to be talking about. It's denaturation of proteins. We're going to take eggs, for example. So when they're raw, they're this clear color. And then when they're cooked, they get that white color. When we're going through that process, we have a chemical change, and that chemical change is the denaturation that happens. Denaturation is a chemical process when a protein unravels and expands due to heat, acid, or salt. To know when this is happening, the signal is the color changing, so between clear, like here, which is clear, and white. So we're going to be talking about the primary structure of a protein. So the primary structure right here, which is also amino acid. So as you can see, is right here. The secondary structure is right here. The tertiary structure is right here, as you can see. If you need a visual, get a paper towel, fold it in half, and this is going to be structure. For the protein, which is in order, the primary structure, the secondary structure is all curled up like this. This is the secondary structure. The tertiary structure, it's all clumped up. For denaturation, this is the process. This is the process where the protein unravels and goes to its primary structure, which is like this. And after that has happened, it can't go back. So that's what denaturation means in a protein. And thanks for listening.